Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Akash and today we will be talking about the next OS which is developed by Google named Fuchsia OS. And this is the code name of next OS. And from past years we were hearing the news about Google's next OS, and today we can get the hands-on experience of early build for Fuchsia OS. And I found this APK on SlashGear website in their recent post. And you can also download the APK and install it on your mobile to experience the next Google OS. So let's get started with the APK. So opening the APK, you will get the interface for your user account, and you can see the profile icon here. So also you will get the calendar view and the time and the battery icon. And further tapping on your profile, now you can see the quick actions notification here, like it is showing us the battery right now and the remaining time, a Wi-Fi quick shortcut and the network quick shortcut. Also you will get the sliders for volume and brightness control with the down quick buttons of flight mode and portrait or landscape mode. And this middle button, I don't know, I think it's a new. And you can also get the option for logout and more, which does nothing on tapping out. So again, clicking on profile icon will get you back to the main screen. And swiping up and down, you can see that this OS is mainly based on the design of Google Cards. So you can see that it is designed as the Google Cards in the rectangular formats. So swiping up from the main screen, you will get the Google search, and tapping in Google search icon, you will get the keypad here. And this keypad is very basic, nothing fancy here, and it's got the new theme of a dark theme. So there are no swipe gestures present in this Google keyboard right now, but a dark theme is nice to see here. Also, if we press outside the Google search button, then you will get back to the home screen. So if you swipe up, so you will get the cards, and these cards are basically your all the apps. So you can see that they have a name like Story MU, Story Lambda, Story Kappa, and like that, different names are there. And also email is present here. And if we open any card or app here, then you can see the app has been opened. Further pressing a click, you will get the full screen layout of the app. If we press the notification drop down like gesture, then you will again get the name of app. And if we press and hold the home icon is present here in the bottom center, then you will get the quick shortcuts for your settings here. So again, pressing the home button will lead you to the main screen. And if you press and hold any of the card and put it in the another app, then basically it will activate the multitasking. So you can see here that the two apps are running individually. So this OS is heavily focused on multitasking. So you can see that. And if you try to add one more app in this multitasking, so let's try it. Yeah, so you can see that three apps are at a time, you can see that. So again, pressing from downside to upward will lead you to get to the Google search icon. And I want to know you guys that this OS is not based on the Linux version, which presently Android operates on it. Has a different kernel which is already made by Google, and also the software development kits for the apps is different. So I will be providing you the app for this APK and the article of SlashGear website in the description down below. So thank you very much guys for watching. Peace.